guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Normal Didi and I make videos on faith, love and general life. If you're a new subscriber, you're welcome to my channel, and if you're a returning subscriber, thank you for coming back. It's good to have you with me. So for today's video, I'm going to be talking about boundaries to have in a dating relationship with members of the opposite sex. Okay, now people think that there's nothing to eat, can't put all my eggs in one basket, blah blah blah. I've heard them all, or I've heard most of them. Well, you don't want your partner feeling like you don't value them enough, or they're not special to you, or like you don't respect them, and you don't want them to be on the side dying with envy and jealousy while you're just there gallivanting with other people. If you love your partner and if you respect them and if you want them to feel valued by you, I'm here to tell you some things that you can do to maintain boundaries. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, what are you waiting for? Why are you darling? Why are you milking me for free without buying the car? Okay, so subscribe to my channel so that you can get notified whenever I post new videos. So without wasting any much of your time, let's head right into the video. Boundary number one is limit the use of terms of endearment. Before I continue, I must say that I've also been guilty of this, so I'm not judging you per se, but I'm judging you still if you do this. I see a lot of people, you're in a relationship, you say that you're in a serious relationship with somebody, but then you'll be calling another guy or another girl boo and baby, honey, oh my love, my sugar, and then if they ask you who is this, you say, we're just friends, he's just my friend. You know, all of you people, especially ladies, you even guys do this too. You just be confusing us that on your social media, or have your number saved on our WhatsApp. You just be confusing us because we don't know who is your real boyfriend, we don't know who is your real girlfriend. You are putting all the guest picture on your status, and then oh sugar, happy birthday Jerry, happy birthday love, happy birthday my love, happy birthday my one and only. If you're in a relationship with somebody, there are certain things that are reserved only for them, and you're not supposed to be sharing it. You are also don't receive it. You may say, I don't talk like that to other guys or other girls, but you receive it, you entertain it, you love it. You are wrong too. You are in this table, you are in this boat, you are on this ship, you are here. I'm talking to you as well. Okay, so don't entertain it. If it's people that you have been friends with before, and let's say you just got into a serious relationship, you can politely talk to them. They are your friends, and I'm sure they'll understand and say, oh please, I would love for you to tone down a bit on this, because I don't know about you, but somebody like me, like, I love to hear praises, I love to hear sweet things, you know, my ears are tingling. I don't know if I say are tingling, but basically they're just something it does to me. So to be very honest with you, there came a time whereby I had to talk to one of my very good friends who I was friends with before I even got into a relationship, but I had to talk to him and say, okay please, could you not call me this or that? I know that I may have condoned this before and have even participated in that, but I had to talk to him, and he was so gracious and he understood. That's because these things can affect me. Another thing is that you don't want to be sending mixed signals to somebody, and then when they start catching feelings for you, you now say, oh no, I'm in a relationship, we're just friends and all that. Please don't do that, okay? Don't do that. So limit and even stop the using terms of endearment. Don't come for me anyway, Sha. This is just my own advice to you. Boundary number two is reduce the frequency with which you talk. Reduce the frequency with which you talk to the opposite sex, and don't take phone calls at odd hours of the day. So you say, oh, she's just a friend, but you guys are busy talking for 7 hours. For 10 hours. First of all, how can you be in a relationship with somebody, in my opinion, that is not your best friend? I believe that, and I think that who you're dating is supposed to be your best friend, at least like your most treasured opposite sex friend. If you're dating somebody that you don't like to talk to or spend time with so much, then why are you dating them? Why are you even thinking of marriage safe in the first place? Because you think in marriage all people do is kiss and cuddle and I don't know, do other things. Do you think that's what they do all day? you're gonna talk, you're gonna have conversations. It's friendship, okay? Friendship is also part of marriage. So if you're in a relationship with somebody that you can't talk to as much as you talk to other ladies or other guys, I think that is a sign that something may be wrong in that relationship, and you're most likely not in the right relationship, or you just need to work on building the friendship that you have with this other person. So let it not be that you talk more to somebody else than you talk to your own partner. People will believe that you're dating somebody else when in fact you are dating this other person. You get, is your girlfriend or your boyfriend just a ceremonial, having a ceremonious boyfriend or girlfriend? I'm not a government student, but I took government for a short while, and then they'll say, oh, this person is for administrative, this one for ceremonial, it's only for show or something like that. Is that what you're doing? Anyway, that's that. Number three is no new personal friends. What I mean by no new personal friends is this: if the relationship is becoming serious and you guys are beginning to consider marriage or you're engaged, any friend that you guys are getting that are members of the opposite sex, let it be your friend, like together, your friends, you understand? Let it not be my friend or his friend. And then you may not agree with me, but this is my personal preference. Don't be going out on personal dates with them. Like I said, I see dating, intentional dating, as a prerequisite. Like, is that thing that kind of sets the pace or sets the tone for marriage? So if you start practicing these things early on, it's really going to be of a great advantage to you in marriage. That's just my personal take, okay? Yeah, so try as much as possible not to be going out on personal dates with somebody other than your boyfriend or your girlfriend or your fiance or your fiance. If you want to go out with a member of the opposite sex, then let it be a group outing, you and your partner, and then that person, or if they also have a partner, together as well. Yeah, another boundary that you need to maintain in your relationship is avoid being an emotional receiver for a member of the opposite sex. You may have friends who want to talk to you about some of the struggles they may be going through. Well, too bad, because you're already taken, and honestly speaking, it's none of your business. Now, I'm not saying that you cannot show sympathy, but I would advise that you refer them to somebody else, maybe a pastor, or don't they have friends of the same sex? If it's a guy, let him talk to his guy friends, or let him talk to his pastor, or somebody from his church, or his brother, or his sister. But please, let it not be you. And if you are a guy, why are you trying to form Prince Charming on top another woman's head when you already have a girlfriend? So the only person that I believe that you are allowed to be an emotional receiver for is your significant other. So if they come to you and then you're trying to pour out and you just need someone to talk to, you love them, you respect them, you care about them, but please tactfully remove yourself from the situation, because if you give them a listening ear the first time, best believe that they will just begin to feel like you are a safe space or a safe place for them to pour out to, and then they're going to keep coming back. That's how emotional affairs start. Then the next boundary is watch the level of physical exchange that both of you have. You know that guys like to tap currents. And you know there are some people that they don't have wisdom. They don't have what we call common sense. They call it common sense, but it's not common. So you see somebody that will see me with my husband. Me, I'm now even my see me with my husband, and they're just like, oh no, my love. And they want me, they want to wrap me, and I'm just like, hell, God have mercy. Common sense is not common. So if you're in a relationship, you may not be married yet, but don't entertain such. Whether you're a girl, whether you're a guy, don't allow anybody to be tapping correct from you like that. And some even do that irrespective of who you are with. It's not proper. So limit the physical exchange between both of you. You can give side hugs, you can do handshake. Oh my God, I remember when me and my husband were dating and we started incorporating this principle, some people were open. I'm like, no, I can't hug you. I think me, I kind of took my own to the extreme, but I was like, I can't hug you. Handshake, when we would walk and talk or something and we're saying goodbye, and then I'll just say okay, bye, and I would shake them. It was so funny, okay? But you don't have to be as extreme as I was, but you can like a side hug or something, but don't let anybody just be wrapping you up in their embrace or, you know, feeling up on you. People can begin to catch feeling like that. People can start have develop sexual urges just from things like that. So please, you don't want to be transmitting and transfusing electricity and fireworks between you and somebody else, okay? When you're in a relationship with somebody else, no, don't do that. Yeah, so guys, I've come to the end of today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. I realized that something that's actually been like limiting me is leaving my flip screen, like facing my, making the flip screen face me. So I said, hey, you know what, I just want to be free. I just want to talk freely. I don't want to feel all stiff and formal, and so I covered it, and that's why you are seeing this, my all over the place attitude. I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you found this video helpful and useful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment in the comment section. Can you relate to some of the things I said? And just let me know basically in the comment section. And yeah, if you're not yet subscribed, also please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I post new videos every week. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.